So there's a secret button on the iPhone that you probably didn't even know about, and some other really cool features that Apple doesn't really talk about all too often. So first, let's show you how you can access that secret button. And what you need to do is open up the Settings app and then go into the Accessibility menu. Now, when you're in this menu, go into the Touch menu and head all the way down towards the very bottom to the Back Tap option. Here you'll find the option to double or triple tap, and for me in this demo, I just want to show you how you can set up the double tap feature. Now in this menu, you can select whichever option you want to access when double tapping the backside of your iPhone around the Apple logo. So now that you've chosen the setting that you wish to access, go ahead and double tap the back of your iPhone, and now you have access to that secret iPhone button Apple doesn't tell you about. Now, another feature Apple doesn't really talk about is the ability to record a video while playing music when shooting a video using their camera app. Now, to get around the camera app stopping your music when you go into the video mode, make sure that you are playing the music that you want to be playing in your video, and then go into the camera app, specifically in the photo mode. Now, when you're in this mode, hold down the shutter button and your video will start recording with the music playing in the background. Now, you can either choose to keep holding the shutter button to continue your recording, or if you don't want to continuously hold that button, you can slide it all the way over to the right for freehand shooting. And when you're done, you can press the stop button when you want your recording to end. So yeah, you don't actually have to use Snapchat or Instagram to record videos with your music playing. All you need to do is just use that method, and not only will you get the same result, your video should have a lot more quality as you're using Apple's built-in camera app. Now, one really cool feature is Apple's built-in music recognition toggle in the Control Center. You definitely don't want to be that one guy that asks your friends or random people around you, "Hey, what song is playing right now?" Or walk around with your iPhone asking Siri, "Hey, what song is playing?" So to avoid those awkward encounters and to also avoid having to download an app, head over to the Settings app and then head down to the Control Center menu. Now in this menu, head down to the Available Toggles and add the Music Recognition toggle. Place it in whatever you order you want to, and now when you go into the Control Center and tap on that toggle, in the Control Center specifically, it will send you a notification of what song is playing in the background. So hopefully after you add that toggle, you'll never have to ask Siri or anyone else what song is playing in the background. Now, another really cool thing that people really don't know about is you can move entire app pages without having to move the apps by themselves or in groups. So to access this feature, go to your home screen and then press and hold on the dots on the bottom representing the pages you have. So once you get into this kind of like jiggle mode with your pages showing, all you have to do is tap and hold on a specific page and move that over to whichever position you want it in. Therefore, you can actually replace your home page with a different page and have that as your default page. A lot of people don't know about that, but that is something you can do here in iOS 15. Now, next up is a really cool Maps feature that you probably don't know about, but one that is actually quite useful. Now, have you ever wanted to know what time you need to leave by to get to your destination at a certain time? You can actually now do that directly in the Maps app. So just head into the Maps app, enter a destination of your choice, and then go ahead and select the Leaving Now option when viewing your route. So you have two options at the top, that being the leave at time, which will tell you what time you'll get there if you leave at a specific time, or you can head over to the arrive by time, which will allow you to essentially give you a time as to when you need to leave by to reach your destination by a certain time. Now, since using the arrive by feature, I personally have never been late, and it's actually been a huge relief to know when I need to leave by versus just guessing and ending up late because I miscalculated. So if you're like me and you hate being late, check out this really cool and handy feature in the Maps app that will save you from being late to any meetings, events, or functions just by using that little handy feature in the Maps app. So guys, did you know about all of those cool features that you can use on your iPhone, specifically here in iOS 15? Let me know in the comment section down below. And also, if you have any secret iOS 15 features of your own that you want to share, leave those in the comment section down below so others can check those out as well. Anyways, guys, make sure to get subscribed to the channel for more useful tutorials like these. And also check out our channel information link down below for giveaways and other really cool things that we have going on.